What's up, everybody? My name is Bo Tyler. I make music. What if I told you that there was a drummer who absolutely belongs in the discussion for Mount Rushmore of drummers, and you don't know this person's name? We're talking about someone who has played or produced on albums for people like Norah Jones, Daft Punk, K-Tronauta, The Roots, Kanye West, Kanye West's friend that he made super famous, Paul McCartney. You remember that dumb shit? But none of those things matter. None of this incredible resume that's so long it would make Tommy Lee's blush. The only thing that matters is one name on that list. This dude made not just one, not two, but three albums with Dilla. We're talking about an all-time jazz and hip-hop drumming great, Kareem Riggins. I hope I said his first name right, because I've never actually heard anyone say his first name out loud, so I could be saying it wrong. But guess what? He just made a plugin with Native Instruments. We're gonna check it out, and I am f***ing pumped. Let's get it. All right, so here it is, Kareem Riggins drums. And if I am saying that wrong, someone tell me so that I don't have to make a fool out of myself when I say this to any more than the few thousand people that will watch this video. Let's go through it very quickly. Just like all Native Instruments Kontakt drum plugins, they all look pretty much the same. We've got our main page, our kit page. You can tailor the sounds of each individual drums. We've got four different inserts that you can put in on all of these with a ton of plugins available, but you can also click on these and reorder them, put different sounds in. That way, if you're not doing them with the layout of how people play drums on a keyboard, you can make it make a little bit more sense with a groove box like an MPC or a machine. Let's close that out. Let's go to the next page. We've got our patterns because you'll see that all the groups are split. You've got individual drum one shots over here, and you've got patterns that you can mix and match over here, and they will always come in on a grid division. So really cool live tool, especially if you're using something like Ableton Link to sync up to the time code of your backing tracks that are running out of Ableton or whatever DAW you use when playing live. We've got our effects page, inserts, global, send effects, and then we've got our macros. I'm not gonna go into all that. We've seen these plugins before and I don't want to be annoying. So here are the parameters you're gonna use most often. If you're using a complete control keyboard like I am, you'll be able to control all of these main dials that you see on the screen, like high pass filter, low pass filter, reverb, lo-fi, punch, sustain, tune, and level. I was gonna play preset roulette, but maybe one downside of this is that there's not a whole bunch of presets, but I don't really care because I just always end up designing my own kits, save the presets, and use them for like a decade because these sort of plugins never age. Let's just go through some of them. So the first preset we've got here is First Bokeh. It recommends 85 beats per minute. All right, let's come in here and I'll just show you. Here's the loops. All right, that's pretty dope. I like that one a lot. I'm not gonna go through all of these. I'm gonna let you know what the plugin is. There's always a ton of great audio samples over at Native Instruments, but let's go through a couple more. We'll pick one we like and we'll put together a quick beat so that I can show you how usable this is, and we'll do some quick edits right inside of the plugin itself. And these are all things that normally we would have to open up several other plugins to get this sound, but it's all right here. Let me show you. So you want that Dilla sound? Use the Dilla drummer. I want to remind everyone, these are not fake drums. These are sampled one-shots, sampled sequences from a genius. I feel like there's always someone that listens to these and goes like, I like real guitar, or I like real drums. They are real drums, they are real guitar. That's what Native Instruments does, and that's why I make so many videos for them. Because I'm a musician, and I just want things to sound mostly real. And then personally, I love taking those really real elements and then really mixing them with something that's really fake. For real. I'm so dumb. Let's keep going. So for how I want to use it, which is like a hi-hat, that's a little bit loud for me. This is a good chance for me to show you what's up. Come in here. Whichever one we've touched, all of the controls on this page just affect that one sound. This is one of the coolest things that Native does, and some other companies do too, but this is called a round robin. If you've ever heard about this but didn't know what they were talking about, this means that this pad or this key contains multiple drum samples so that it changes. Sometimes these things change based on velocity, sometimes it's random, sometimes they just repeat over and over. Once they reach the end of the list, it starts over. You can tell a real drummer made this plugin because this is a very drummer thing to want to do. Drummers do not like hearing the same snare drum all song long because that's not what drums sound like. Check it out. Now, I actually can't quite tell if those are different samples or if that's just running through some sort of envelope, but that's dope. So that sound, I want to have a little bit more on it. Let's go ahead and add a compressor just to that snare. And then if we come over here on the effects page and click on our inserts, there's our compressor. Yeah, right about there. All right, so let's keep going. I'm gonna show you a few more, but I'm gonna do it very quickly by just showing you what the sound of them are by using the loops, because I'm getting pumped up and I'm ready to make something. And talking to you all about music rather than making music is a little bit like torture. So in the spirit of wanting to hurry up, let's do our favorite game, preset roulette. I do want to show you that there are some really cool tools in here. When I say that one of the best things about these drum plugins is that you don't have to use a lot of other plugins you normally would, here is one of the best examples I can show you. Having a high pass and a low pass filter already dedicated here for the plugin, you can do huge buildups in the style of like EDM, like something like this. We've also got a delay in here, which can be really cool. I recommend putting little delays on things like hi-hats. You can mess up the timing a little bit and kind of force that Della vibe, but you can do stuff like this. All right, I don't want to wait anymore. Let's put this thing to the test. So that we have something to play along with on drums, let me come in here. I'm going to open up Contact 7. Let's just use Native's most recent one. Let's use Duets, yeah? So many plugins, oh my God. Go 25%. Just in the name of keeping the ball rolling, let's add a bass in here just to kind of finish off this beat. I'm gonna use my favorite bass plugin of all time. It's from Output. It's called Substance. You can buy it from Sweetwater. You can buy it from Native Instruments. I'll put links in the description below. So yeah, let's do bass stuff. Let's turn a gate on here and let's make the bass the side chain. So then finally we've got this all in about, I don't know, 10 minutes. Anyway, yeah, no more talking. Let me know what you thought about the plugin or the plugins that I used. Or just, you know, say hi. Hi, Bo. I saw the video. Hi. Any of that good stuff, just like, subscribe, and drop a comment, and I'll be happy. Either way, thank you so much for watching. My name is Bo Tyler. We made a little bit of music, and yeah.